Hey everyone, welcome back to another video here on the HVT channel. Today we're finally getting you the video on cleaning the Hyperion. You couldn't tell by everything here. And please give Elisa a nice warm welcome. Gonna try not to punch her in the head this week. But she's the girl. Oh, there we go. Get to your order. So give her a big warm welcome and a thank you. But yeah, this is Elisa.
Hi.
So first we're going to tell you all the stuff that you need to clean your Hyperion.
So you're going to need your Hyperion, of course.
Right. Yeah.
You're going to need your 90% alcohol or more. We got some Q-tips that comes with your Hyperion, some alcohol wipes, and you will need something to soak it. We forgot our tubs.
So please don't judge our mugs that don't fit the items very well.
It's before 8:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
We're not functioning very well yet.
We've been here since before 8, so. And it's Friday, so it's a little early. So first we're going to take our little tub slash mug. We're going to fill it with some alcohol. Shouldn't be doing this left-handed. Seems like enough, right?
Yes. That's good.
It's spilling on me. fuck. Shoot, I mean, fudge. Okay, so we're gonna fill your tub with some alcohol, and then you're gonna take the glass bubbler part off. Just be really careful, because it's glass. You're just gonna kind of wiggle, and yeah. And take that off first.
And then you'll drop it right into the alcohol to let it soak.
Your little Hyperion bath. Oh,
just that's too much.
Send it here.
That works.
Send it.
That works.
So if you have the right stuff, it works a little bit. I forgot about the I'm not good at volume. Next we're gonna get started on the coil. I think if you're really skilled, you can probably take this little thing off its lanyard. I'm not going to try that because I got nails and we're not going there. Then you're going to take your coil out. This is an X score. But say if you, depending on how much you use your coils, they may or may not be very dirty. So like if your bucket is not that bad, you can take a Q-tip. Why do I look like a child doing everything? So you can take a Q-tip, you can use Q-tip brand if you're out of these, soak it a little bit, and just, that's the wrong one, you can't see, but if you have your bucket, you can just swab it out like so. If it is really gross, you can just take it apart and soak it in like a container that's a little flatter, so you can
not just put the whole coil in there.
Yeah, the titanium. Fuck, shoot. The titanium part, you can just throw that whole part in there. But any of your coils with the little... What's that
called? The insulator?
Yeah, those.
The rubber part on there?
You want to put them like face down like this in more of a flat container. Or one of these that's not as filled. So, like this, I guess you can see the little white part sticking out.
Although we don't always listen to our own advice, we definitely don't listen to our own advice.
On this subject particularly.
We recommend swapping your coils out every couple of hits, just so it doesn't get too nasty. It gets nasty sometimes.
The bucket coils, we wouldn't recommend it on the hex core because I haven't really tried it. But I just have a feeling like it's going to pick up cotton off the Q-tip and it's going to be gross. So maybe not on the hex core. You try it, let us know. if somehow the base of your Hyperion is really gross, I feel like saying if somehow is a little condescending. Sorry if you're out there and your base is gross. I'm not trying to call you out. But
we know from experience that they get dirty.
We've got some sent back. We're like, how did you do? Anyways. take your silicone base off, or the cover off, and you can just also soak it. In a regular tub, not this. See, the cap's not even alcohol. And if the battery part is dirty, also somehow, you can wipe it out with a little alcohol swab.
If you don't got that, you can use your alcohol and some napkins.
That's clever. Mm-hmm. Look at you improvising. So smart. So yeah, you can wipe it down if you need to.
Then all I have to do is take everything out of the alcohol, of course.
You know, of course.
And then set it like on a napkin or something and let it sit for 24 hours to let it dry.
Yeah, you don't want to inhale any
alcohol. Stinks.
Yeah, and it's probably not, I don't think it's good for you.
I don't think so either.
not any actual medical advice here, but we wouldn't recommend that. And as per usual, if you have any questions, just drop a comment. Don't always see those right away on YouTube because I suck. So you can also email us, get a hold of us on Instagram, or give us a ring at the office, or
call the 844 oil coil number.
Yeah, hit Vic up anytime.
I don't think he answers his phone from like 10 o'clock at night to 9 a.m. California time.
But it doesn't hurt to try, you know? Anyways, tell him we sent you. And let us know what you guys want to see on the next video. That's all, right?
Yeah, I think that's all.
All right, see you guys later. Bye. Is that a nice warm welcome? This girl, let's do that. Just accidentally assaulted my coworker. Sorry. This is why I finally was able to talk her into doing a video. I sometimes accidentally assault her. And she's like, no.
I'm used to it.
It's totally not a regular thing in the office. It's our free time.
No, not at all.
But yes, so Elise is finally here doing a video with me. I forgot to turn the light on.
It's a run. It's a run. Anyways. Anyways.
It's okay.
Did that work? I just laughed so hard. I made my face
back.
Oh, it's a video.
Now
I'm
gonna open these. I mean fudge. I can do it. I should reseal it for the video. Like the real video.
It says. Although we don't always listen to our own advice,
on this,
we do recommend swabbing your coils out every couple months, hit so it doesn't get too nasty, because it gets nasty sometimes. Trust me.
However, if you're Lisa, you just steal a new coil.
Yeah, that's what I do all the time.
But everyone else, take a new coil.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Don't tell me.
Privileges.
He's not going to watch this, right?
I hope not.